Hello friends, patch 11.10 notes are out and I am here to read them to you so that you don't have to and you can just hopefully throw this on in the background. Authors, as always, are Momcat and Shio Shoujo. I was given the suggestion of not doing background music. So for this one, it's just going to be me, myself, and the patch notes. Alright, let's get going. First, we have Bard. Passive base damage has been decreased. Passive, Traveler's Call. Base damage went from 40 to 30. Darius, E cooldown increased. E, Apprehend, cooldown went from a base of 24 to 26, going down by 2 seconds for each rank. Galio, W cooldown now flat. Magic damage shield decreased. W, Shield of Durand, cooldown has now gone to a flat 18 seconds. Magic damage shield now increases by 1.75% of maximum health. Jinx, base armor decreased, R damage now capped against epic monsters. Base stats armor went from 28 to 26. R, Super Mega Death Rocket, new smaller Mega Death Rocket. Execute damage against epic monsters is now capped at 1,000. AoE damage is capped at 800. Katarina, base movement speed decreased. Base stats, movement speed went from 340 to 335. Kale, passive AP damage ratio and bonus attack range increased. Muramana bug fix. Passive Divine Ascent. A flame AP damage ratio went from 20% to 25%. Transcendent bonus attack range went from 50 to 100 with 625 total. Muramana bug fix. Kale's fire weaves now. Muramana bug fix. Kale's fire waves now properly apply Muramana's shock. Kennen. W max stacks bonus damage increased. W, Electrical Surge, maximum stack bonus damage went from 10 to 20, increasing by 10 with each rank, with 25% AP. Lux, E, damage increased. E, Lucent Singularity, damage remains at a base of 60, but now increases by 50 with each rank, plus 65% AP. Sejuani, E, targeting updated. Prioritizes champions within 50 of cursor, then non-champions within 50 of cursor, then champions within 350 of cursor, then closest unit to cursor within 2,500. This only applies if there's no target directly under your cursor. Talon, Q bonus AD damage ratio decreased. Q, Noxian Diplomacy, went from 110% bonus AD to 100% bonus AD. Thresh, base health decreased, health growth increased. Base stats, health went from 501 to 530, health growth went from 93 to 95. Yumi, Q base damage and empowered damage increased, W ally icon bug fix. Q, prowling projectile, base damage went from 40 to 50, increasing by 30 with each rank. Base empowered damage went from 45 to 60, increasing by 40 with each rank. W, Yuumi, ally icon bug fix. Yuumi's ally's level icon now properly reverts back to normal when Yuumi detaches from said ally. Zyra, passive Vine Lasher slow increased, W cooldown decreased. Passive, Garden of Thrones, Vine Lasher slow went from 25% to 30%. W, Rampant Growth, cooldown went from a base of 20 to 18, decreasing by 2 seconds with each rank. Items, Abyssal Mask. Health went from 350 to 400, Unmake Damage Ratio went from 10% to 15%, Unmake Duration went from 4 seconds to 5 seconds. Gore Drinker, Thirsting Slash Healing went from 25% AD plus 8% of missing health, to 25% AD plus 10% of missing health. Ginsu's Rage Blade went from a combined cost of 1,100 gold to 900 gold. Rift Maker, Combat Trigger went from dealing damage to enemy champions to dealing damage to and taking damage from enemy champions. Void Corruption increased damage per second, went from 2% stacking up to 5 times to 3% stacking up to 3 times for a maximum of 9%. Runes, Phase Rush. Cooldown is from 15 seconds to 3 through 10 seconds based on level. Bonus movement speed went from 40% to a starting 30% to 60% for melee and 15% to 40% for ranged. Jungle update. This is a little bit of a long one, so hang out with me here. Jungle timers and camp gold. Camp respawn timer went from 2 minutes to 2 minutes and 15 seconds. Camp respawn glowing indicator went from 15 seconds before camp spawns to 10 seconds before camp spawns. Comeback experience, the comeback kid. When a jungler is at least 2 levels below the average level of all players in the game, they get increased experience from large and epic monsters. These camps will grant 50 experience more per level below the average level of all players in the game. Smite. Smite damage from monsters went from a base of 390 to 450 at base and then 900 after smite quest completion. New unsealed spellbook swap smite damage. Smite damage now increases after swapping summoner spells twice. New scuttle on back. Smite and any crowd control now breaks Rift Scuttle shield before applying damage. Survivability. Omnivamp on jungle items went from 10% to 8%. Smite heal from max health went from 10% to 15%. Jungle monster camp changes. And to top it all off, we adjusted specific jungle camps based on our overarching goals. 1. Reduce incoming damage from jungle camps to offset the reduced healing from Omnivamp. 2. Change jungle monster's health to offset the higher smite damage. And 3. Change gold values to offset income lost by spawn timers. Jungle camp attack damage for all of these is levels 1 through 18. Blue Sentinel is 78 to 234. Red Brambleback is 78 to 234. Gromp as well is 78 through 234. Merkwolf is 35 to 105. Smaller Merkwolves are 10 to 30. Crimson Raptor is 20 to 60. Raptors are 10 to 30. Big Krug is 78 to 234. Medium Krug is 2 to 60. Oops. Medium Krug is 20 to 60. And mini Krugs are 13 to 39. Jungle Camp Health. Blue Sentinel is 1850 to 3238. Red Brambleback is 1850 to 3238. And then Rift Scuttler is 1050 to 2170. Jungle Camp Gold, Mini Krug is 13, Merkwolf is 65, Gromp is 90, and Crimson Raptor is 45. VFX updates. Kog'Maw, passive Acathian Surprise. Reduce noise and improve clarity with regards to the size of the explosion. Basic attack, new missiles and hit effects. Q, Caustic Spittle. New hit effects and a new missile to better represent its actual hitbox. W, Bio Arcane Barrage, new effects to make Kog'Maw more representative of the Void. E, Void Ooze, new hit effects and a new missile to better represent its actual hitbox. R, Living Artillery, new effects that better represent the hitbox. Kog'Maw skins, base Kog'Maw, updated character texture. Reindeer, added new recolors to all VFX. Deep Sea, new colors as well. That also goes for Jurassic Kog'Maw. Lion Dance Kog'Maw is new unique VFX on E, updated R and Q VFX. Pug'Maw, all VFX updates. All other Kog'Maw skins are R updated to show hitbox more clearly. Bug fixes and QOL changes. I'm going to try and zoom through this. It's a little bit long. Updated the widths of Pike's E, Phantom Undertow's VFX to better match the hitbox. Fixed a bug where Prowler's Claw Sandswipe would only work on champions, not other targets like minions. Fixed a bug where Sanguine Blade's healing from physical vamp against champions counter so that it accurately displays the amount of healing the user receives. Aurelion Soul's Q, Star Surge's stun, and R Voice of Light's knockup are no longer delayed by up to 0.25 seconds. The Rift Herald will no longer spawn the wrong way. Fix a bug where Fizz was unable to gain Tear of Goddess stacks when killing minions with WC Stone Trident. When a player completes Cull's Reap's minion kill requirement via their ally's Relic Shield Spoils of War, the player now properly gains the 350 gold from Cull. Yone's Q, Mortal Steel, no longer only activates Navori Quickblade at point-blank range. Navori Quickblade now properly triggers when Yasuo uses his E, Sweeping Blade, and Q, Steel Tempest combo. If a player's inventory is full and they sell their trinket, attempting to purchase a ward stone will no longer subtract its gold cost given that the player's inventory is full. Fix a bug where melee champions would gain 54% bonus attack range from rapid fire cannon instead of the expected 35%. Thus, the dance no longer extends aspect of the dragon's burn damage longer than intended, 3 seconds. Fix a bug where Fiddlesticks passive, a harmless scarecrow effigies, would not be usable for the rest of the game if the user sold their Poro snacks at the shop in ARAM. Fix a bug where Akali would deal double E shuriken flip damage if her target was very close to a wall. Vladimir no longer becomes targetable when his W Sanguine Pool ends after using Zhonya's Hourglass Stasis during the ability. Upcoming skins include Arcana Lucian, Tahm Kench, Xerath, and Camille. There will also be chromas for each of the new skins. And that's it for the 11.10 patch notes. As always, if you enjoyed this, please be sure to subscribe. And if you have any feedback, thoughts, let me know in the comments below. And I would love to hear what you think about these patch notes and what is to come on the Rift.